Welcome friends, today in this video I am going to taught you how you can make a image slider using HTML and CSS. Here this is the example that I have made in by the help of HTML and CSS. So you have to notice that each slide stay for 4 seconds and after 4 seconds the another one slide take place the first one slide. So to make code this, you have to come to your desktop. I have created a folder named new folder. If I click to it, here you can see the four images of equal width and equal height. When I hover to it, then its dimension is reflected. Its dimension is 1280 × 719. So we have to just remember that width of each four images must be same. So here I have index.html for my markup and here I have style.css. Let's open with it the text editor. The text editor that I have used is VS Code. Here there have been four images displayed and index.html written nothing and style.css for styling or markup. So in this index.html, let's code. You have to create a div with the ID container. And creating, then you have to create a div of ID slidebar. And here you have to paste all the four images that you have selected for your slide image slider. First one image. Then here we go for second one image and here third one image will come place and here this will be fourth one. So let's open with the live server so that we can check whether what are the information that has been in it. So first image is here and if we scroll down, then there has been a image displayed. To let's slide this for making the image slider, first we style the slide bar of width. You have to notice that I have to calculate its width using calculator, that each image dimension was 1280 pixels × 4 images, so I get 5120. So write it here, saving it. And then position is relative. Remember, if you don't put the relative position, then the image will not slide. Put a animation, simple animation, name is animate, then for 20 seconds and known and infinite. So this is the basic. Here let's see what are the changes has been seen in our HTML or markup. So nothing so hard. And then coming on to the slide bar, here images, then in this float left. So after floating, I have not linked this file, so I have to link style.css. After linking it, you can see that all the images have been in a vertical, so this is perfect for it. Then let's code further. Then code to the container part. Its width will be 1280 pixels, because our first image dimension is 1280 pixels. Then coming to the height, height will take 100 VH according to the viewport height. Then margin, we will take auto. And here border radius 10 pixels, or you can take more according to your choice how it will look nice. So here the border you can take upon your choice. If you want, then you can put it, or if you don't want, then don't put it, depend upon your choice. Here let's preview it, then you can see that each images of our is looking pretty good. But you see that there has been still a horizontal scroll bar. So to neglect this, here write overflow hidden. So this is the first part of it. Let's calculate other things. Open the calculator. In 20 second our animation will take 100%. So 100% divided by 20 second equal to 5. So you have to remember that basic calculation, that in 20 second our animation will take place 100%. So what will be the result if there has been 1 second? Then it will have an impact of 5%. So this is the basic calculation that you must require, and saving, and you have to require one more calculation, that in 4 seconds there have been 20% of completion. Let's create the keyframe. Let's click upon this, and 0%, starting from 0%, the left will be 0, and then coming to the other part after 4 seconds. After 4 seconds, I am writing that after 4 seconds, after 4 seconds, it will be 20%. So yahan this, there will be a 20% of increment. Then left will be 0 pixel again. Then in the 5% of this, there have been an increment, that other slide will take place of the first one slide. So here's on for 25%, and left will be -1280 pixel. I hope that you are getting my point, what I am trying to convey you. And then next, after 4 seconds, and then adding 45%, 20% means you can calculate it. After saving all the changes, you can see that I have created all the animation with the perfect calculation. Let's see what is the result. So you have to notice that each slide stay for 4 seconds, and after 4 seconds another slide take place the first one slide position. So if this video was helpful in a way, then please like this video. And if you have some queries or any further doubts, then you can comment it down. If you require some improvement in this video quality, so you can comment it, so that I, in the next video, upcoming videos, I can improve it in the future. Thank you.